Use headphones for best experience. Thanks for your fantastic. Since I posted the drawing map of the USA video a couple of weeks ago, and I asked for suggestions for US states that I could draw, and I couldn't imagine I would get so much response for that video, so much positive response and so many great suggestions. And Texas was by far the most requested state. So I decided to give it a try today to draw this state, and it's been very fun to do some research again. I must say I didn't know much about Texas actually, not the geography, not the history, and yeah, so it's so nice to have a reason for doing some research and learn new stuff. It's like going back to school, but just doing the fun stuff somehow. It was also requested that I would do some kind of drawing on this surface, the same that I use in the intro, and also using the same type of pen. So I will try that today. First I need to do some kind of rough sketch here of Texas. See if I can use this white pen again. It's actually a correction pen, or like a tip X-Pen. So I guess the purpose of it is not to draw actually, it's to like paint over something you already have written or drawn. So here the state border follows the Red River, that's why it has this complicated shape. So here it doesn't follow a river, but here again it follows the Sabine River. Here it reaches the coast. Here we have another straight line. Here it follows the Rio Grande. So now we have the coast. It's, I guess it's the most complicated shape to draw. It's almost like a curved line like this, but then there are lots of bays. Here's one, and then there are like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here's an area of the coast that doesn't have this type of islands. Otherwise, I guess they follow all the coast all the way to Louisiana, to the east. So, like I said, this is the Rio Grande. It's a really long river, separate Texas from Mexico. Area of Texas to the west, the Big Bend, from the Great Plains in the center, the hill country. across the border to the east, to the Sabine River. Actually, it's the biggest lake in Texas, and it's located right at the border between Texas and Louisiana. And it's a man-made reservoir called the Toledo Bend Reservoir. The Sabine River goes like this. From this bay here, the Trinity Bay, we have another river. Livingston, one of the biggest lakes in Texas, and the Trinity River starts here in the Dallas-Fort Worth metropolitan area, where there are a lot of cities that has kind of merged together into one big metropolitan area. Then we have a river here called the Brazos. Eastern border of Texas, between Oklahoma and Texas, something like this. Also, we have a section of the Canadian River here to the north. See, there are a lot of bays. Actually, it starts, I always think of it the opposite way, but I mean a lot of rivers ends up here. So we have, I'll draw a few examples here. We have the Colorado River, really long river. Up here in the Matagorda Bay. Passes Austin, capital city. In Texas. Smaller rivers, Guadalupe and San Antonio Medina. That is the major rivers that I would like to show you today. Now, let's draw some cities. We have Austin, I mentioned before. Located here Colorado River, and it's the capital of the state. We have San Antonio by the San Antonio River. Christi by the Corpus Christi Bay here at the Gulf Coast. And we have Houston, biggest city. Then we have Dallas, we're Plano, like a suburb to Dallas, almost. Arlington and Fort Worth. So I guess these four cities and a lot more cities in this area are considered almost like one big city. It's called the Dallas-Fort Worth Metropolitan. To the north we have a city called Amarillo. Here to the very west we have El Paso. It's quite remote. It's one of the biggest, at least one of the 10 biggest cities, I think. But it's really far to the west. And I guess this is quite remote and quite empty of cities, this area here. And to the very south we have Brownsville. Also had some requests for cities to point out. So we have the city of Spearman, very north there on the Panhandle. And I read that it is famous for its collection of windmills from the J.B. Buchanan Windmill Collection. Also that it was like founded when it was decided that a new railway should be built between Oklahoma and northern Texas in 1917, I think. I think it was called the North Texas and Santa Fe Railway. I guess the history of these cities, that's a part of that history, why it was founded. And then we have to the very south, La Feria, close to Brownsville. Also, we have this island, this super long island, it's called Padre Island, reaches all the way to Corpus Christi. The coast outside Corpus Christi, and the southern part of it is called the South Padre Island. And we have Magnolia Beach. It should be this bay here, the Matagorda Bay. I think I can point out the bays. It's between the mainland and Padre Island. It's called the Laguna Madre. This body of water. Then we have the Baffin Bay here, and the Corpus Christi Bay, and then this part of the islands is called the Mustang Island, and then Matagorda Island, Aransas Bay, just outside the Aransas National Wildlife Refuge, and Copano Bay. Matagorda Bay, Magnolia Beach, and here we have Galveston, very popular vacation spot, I guess. A lot of beaches. Galveston, this is called the Galveston Island, and Galveston Bay, and Trinity Bay. I think I zoom in a bit. Galveston Bay and Trinity Bay. This is the Trinity River. Ending up in the Trinity Bay. And this is Houston. Brazos River, we have also Waco. Let's see. Here somewhere. And Bryan. Two cities. Continue to the south and to the north west. It's part of the Rocky Mountains, actually, like an extension, southern extensions of the Rocky Mountains. And here we have Guadalupe Mountains. So read about the Xisos Mountains National Park here to the south, the mountainous area. Some more lakes as well. So I already mentioned the Lake Livingston on the Toledo Bend Reservoir. We also have a quite large reservoir here, Sam Rayburn, and we have a big lake right at the border between Texas and Oklahoma, so I guess that's why it's called Lake Texoma. So you can see there are a lot of lakes here to the center and towards the east part of the state. Yeah, the mountainous areas are here. The rest of the state, I believe, is quite flat. But there's a couple of different like areas or vegetation areas, I guess. So we have the forested area to the east. Some green trees here to the very east. And this region is called the Piney Woods. And this area, not this region, it's not like a, it's not an official region, but referred to as the Piney Woods. And we have the Gulf. Also like an area you can talk about when you talk about Texas. Along the coast, of course. Then we have the South Texas Plains. inserts here, this area. Here at least there are some hills, not just flat landscape. I think Austin is considered to be part of this area. And San Antonio is considered part of the South Texas Plain. See, there are many lakes here. And I guess Dallas is considered part of this area. So this is called the Blackland Prairie, named for the deep, fertile black soils that can be found here. Because it's a lot of farming farms, big farms here. Use this light orange for the last area that I would like to draw, the Panhandle Plains. And this eastern part of it could be called the Rolling Plains. I guess there are just very flat landscape here, and here to the west it's called the High Plains, so more close to the mountains. Sense with these colors, it was quite improvised. Can add some more green here to the forest, and also this transition between the Great Plains and the forests can be referred to as the post-oak savanna. I guess there are some trees here as well, but not as much as in the forest. super happy with the color of the cities. I think it looks quite pale on this black background, so I'll add some red. Now I remember I have a few more requested cities to add. There are some cities here close to San Antonio and Austin. We have Georgetown, just a little bit northeast of Austin. And we have Brown Fells by the Guadalupe River between San Antonio and Austin. New Brown Fells, it's called. Also San Marcos. Here, between New Brown Fells and Austin. Maybe I should add a city here in the forest region, the Piney Woods as well. I guess there aren't any big cities here, but I could add Longview. Here, by the Sabine River. So I would like to show you that the Gulf of Mexico. So, let's talk a bit about the history of Texas. In 1519, the first Spanish conquistadors discovered this place, and then of course there were a lot of Native Americans living here, and I think the language they spoke, and I mean like the tribe, the Native American tribes here to the west, were the Lipan, Apache, and Humano Indians. And then to the south there were a lot of desert, but they were like, we have the Coahuila. Coahuila is actually a state in Mexico here, and also in name of the Native Americans, the Coahuiltecan tribes here in this area. And then we had the Carrancava here by the coast, and Tonkava a little further north along the coast, and in the this Gulf Coast area, and the Caddo here in the forested area, and Wichita here, and the Comanche tribes here. For the first like 160 years or so, Spanish didn't care so much about this area. They kind of left it, focused on the colonies through the south. But then in 1682, the French came from the north instead. So they traveled along the Mississippi River and made the whole area around the Mississippi River to the French colony, Louisiana. And then they actually split the Spanish, the New Spain from Spanish Florida. Florida was also a Spanish colony at this point. So I guess the Spanish didn't like that. Also, the French constructed a fort called Fort St. Louis here, quite close to the Magnolia Beach, actually, where the Magnolia Beach is today. And that became the capital of Texas. So then it was French, under French control. Then there was a century of much conflict between the Spanish and the French about whose colony this was, and it was sold, and yeah, a lot of politics during the wars at this time, during the Quadruple Alliance War and during the Seven Years' War. So in 1762, yeah, in 1720, something like that, or 1729, after the Quadruple Alliance War, then the Spanish built a new fort here, and that became the new capital, the new Spanish capital of Texas, or Texas. But that location is actually now in Louisiana, so it's eastern of the Sabine River. And that fort was called Los Andes. And then after the Seven Years' War, the French ceded all of Louisiana west of Mississippi to Spain. So then it was definitely Spanish again. But then in 1799, Spain gave Louisiana back to France, because I guess there was something else, some area in the world, I think it was in Italy, that they wanted, so they kind of traded. And then after the Napoleon War, Napoleon sold Louisiana to the US. So then it was like, then the United States had its western border here, and then in 1821 Mexico won its independence from Spain, so then it wasn't Spain anymore, it was Mexico, and this was like a state in Mexico, and this state was called Coahuila y Texas. And then in 1836, Texas revolted and gained independence. So it was an actually independent republic between 1836 and 1845. And 1845, it became a state of the United States. So it was like kind of different steps to go from Spanish to Mexican to independent state to state in the US. And also in between 1861 and 1865, it was part of the Confederate States of America during the Civil War. So because of this, all this long history, it has been called, or you can kind of read the history in the sentence, Six Flags Over Texas. And actually, I think I will try to draw these six flags. So I'm gonna draw the six flags over Texas. And I'll start with the Spanish flag. Or I guess it's an old Spanish flag used for the New Spain colonies in the 16th century. These red squares is gonna be two castles, and the white squares is gonna be two lions. Castilla y León. Trying to draw perfect lines here, just want to show you the idea of the flag. At least let's pretend that. Here we have the castles. French colonies in America during the 17th century. And again, I'll not draw it very accurate. This looks like crosses, but it's supposed to be lilies. There are just so many of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six flags over Texas. And now it's time for the flag of Mexico. And a worm, no, sorry, a snake. And some decoration. Some shapes to these two flags later. Just let the ink dry a bit. Now we have the flag of Confederate States of America. also one of the six plagues of Texas. I guess you all know the last flag that I'm gonna draw. The United States of America. And all of a sudden we have not 7 but 13 stripes if we count. Some blue details on these castles. I really like these pictures of these castles. Maybe not on my flag, but on the original flag. Castillas y León. I could give these lines an eye each. This looks really... I have to fix that as well, but then now I have to wait a bit. I'll use this white pen instead. Now for the Republic of Texas, we have the Lone Star. Actually a nickname for the state of Texas, Lone Star. And 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here it should be 7 stars in a circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I'm not sure, but could this be the number of states that was part of this Confederate States of America during 1861 and 1865. And here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times 4 stars. And I make dots instead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4. Better, I think. This still looks like a monkey to me. But anyway. And here they are. The six flags over Texas. That tells a lot about the history of this doing this. It was actually quite fun. And thank you so much for requesting the map of Texas. Thank you so much for your support, for subscribing, for leaving comments. Even if I don't reply to all comments, I read them and usually I put a heart icon on the comment when I read it, just to show that I appreciate it a lot. It's really, actually, a really nice way to support my channel, because every action, every like and commenting, subscribing, any activity on the channel actually helps the channel grow. So please keep commenting. And I'm so glad you watch my videos, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you found it relaxing. Like I said in the beginning, it's so nice to have a reason for doing research, and I feel like I've been really humbled and lucky that I can do this now. Most of my time actually I spend on the channel doing research, recording and editing, uploading. Kind of combines all things I've done before in my life, what I have enjoyed the most, like drawing, working with maps, sometimes done. I mean, not working with maths, but it's been a hobby for all my life. And also kind of going back to school. I was never comfortable leaving school in a way. So several times I have returned to school taking new courses, and I just don't feel I belong to the office environment. Like I've said in some previous videos, vlog, ramble videos, I feel really uncomfortable. But this is really nice. I can do, have like a project. It's like, I really feel like I'm back to school. I have, this week I have a project, I have to do something about Texas. So I have to do some research, I have to write, I have to record, I have to present it to you. And next week it will be something else. And I learn a lot from it. Hope you learn as well. If I can add sources as well, because I hope you don't use this as an education, because I'm just learning just as you do. I'm not an expert on any of the topics I talk about in my videos, so the main sources, I guess I will put a link to those in the video description. Sometimes you ask actually in the comments. I'll be better doing that. So much for watching. Sleep well. Take care. And see you soon.